On this edition of One Championship Weekly, on the 6th of October, get ready for the biggest blockbuster in One Championship history when One Kingdom of Heroes electrifies Bangkok's Impact Arena with the world's most exciting martial arts action. For the first time ever, a boxing bout will take place in the home of martial arts, and it will be a massive world title contest. Headlining the event is one of the world's top pound-for-pound boxers, Thai national hero Srisaket Sor Rungvisai, who will defend his WBC Super Flyweight World Championship against WBC Latino Super Flyweight Champion Iran Diaz of Mexico. And in the co-main event, One kickboxing atomweight world champion Kai Ting Chuang defends her title against striking sensation Stamp Fairtex from Thailand. You're watching One Championship Weekly. It is set to be the biggest martial arts event in the nation's history, featuring mixed martial arts, kickboxing, Muay Thai, and boxing bouts. In the main event, Thai hero Srisaket Sor Rungvisai defends his world title for the first time on home soil against Mexico's fastest rising boxing talent, Iran Diaz. Diaz is desperate to make good on the promise of becoming a world champion and prove that a street kid can rise to the top.
Para mí representar México ha sido mi sueño. Salir y que escuchar el himno nacional representando tu país, yo creo que es el orgullo más grande tanto para mí, para mi familia, para mis amigos y yo creo que todo el país, que un muchacho vaya a representar el país es algo genial, es algo grandísimo para todos nosotros. En cualquier otro país, en cualquier otra república, en cualquier parte del mundo que se presente un mexicano, es garantía de espectáculo, es garantía de golpes, es garantía de que va a ser una pelea durísima, que no va a ser nada fácil para el rival. ¿Por qué? Porque nosotros tenemos demasiada hambre para salir adelante. Tenemos esas ganas de ser campeón del mundo, de salir de pobre, de salir de todo eso, es demasiado. La verdad que me siento muy emocionado porque esta no va a ser la primera vez que voy a representar mi país y para mí es un orgullo y una emoción muy grande.
In the co-main event, One kickboxing atomweight world champion Kai Ting Chuang defends her title against striking sensation Stamp Fairtex from Thailand. We relive the night when Kai Ting Chuang made history when she pulled off a dominant win over Yodcherry Sityadtong to claim the inaugural One kickboxing atomweight world championship title. All three judges scored the bout in favor of Chuang to win by unanimous decision. We join the action in round five.
Unofficially, I would have Kai Ting Chuang ahead at the moment, but Yodcherry is far from done. This crowd in Guangzhou on the edge of their seats for this one. 3 minutes remaining of what has been a fantastic contest. There's the right hand, and Yodcherry fires back. There's the right roundhouse kick from Yodcherry. And now you can feel the aggressive meter has really risen. The adrenaline is pumping in both of these athletes. The temperature has risen inside the Tianhe Gymnasium.
Now, Yodcherry is not backing up. She's standing her ground and exchanging. She's not letting Kai Ting Chuang push her back.
Yodcherry got that right roundhouse kick set to launch. There she goes, and she goes to the waist.
See how she's dropping that hand to parry? Right as there, right there, right as, oh, beautifully timed right hand.
That one was caught plumb on the nose. Takes her down as Yodcherry Sityadtong. No knockdown there, of course. It was a beautiful takedown if this was under our global rule set.
I think Reese McLaren liked that one.
Front kick there, high check from Kai Ting Chuang. Yodcherry has certainly upped her aggression in this final round. You see Kai Ting Chuang has practiced in training, catching the roundhouse kicks off the right leg and countering them with the right hands.
Right now it would be perfect for Yodcherry to go up top. Kai Ting Chuang's reaching for that low kick, fake the low kick, question mark, boom, head kick.
You called it, Mitch, question mark kick, Brazilian kick, whatever you want to call it, it would work right now for Yodcherry Sityadtong. Both ladies trained the knees, and referee Onari breaks them. We've only got 1:10 remaining for the world title. Who's going to become the atomweight champion? Dancing is Kai Ting Chuang. There's the roundhouse kick from Yon Cherry. Doubles up on the catch and counter from the Chinese athlete. Backs her against the ropes. Under a minute to go now. Who is going to put the foot down? Who's going to press the turbo? And Kai Ting Chuang dancing again, trying to confound Yon Cherry Sichitong. There's the roundhouse kick. It stops Kai Ting in her tracks. And again, catch and counter. That's the game plan. Beautiful front kick from Yon Cherry off the rope. Catch and counter again from Kai Ting Chuang. 20 seconds now, Dragon.
Yon Cherry needs to fake that roundhouse kick and throw a punch. Kai Ting Chuang is consistently dropping that lead hand. It's there, the question mark, the head kick is there.
We're gonna go down to the judges, unless there's one big salvo left, the right hand from Kai Ting Chuang. Yon Cherry tries for a knee, puts on the knee guard. And we've gone down to the judges in Guangzhou. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries, or live on the One Super App, how do you score it?
Wow, the young ladies put on a show in Guangzhou. Look at this back and forth action, the combinations. Look at that, beautiful, caught the low kick, spun it to the side, came straight through with the right hand. Inside the clinch, this is that headlock takedown. Oh, puts Kai Ting Chuang on her back again. Catches the body kick and throws that pinpoint right hand over and over again. What a match.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, the One Super Series Kickboxing Atomweight World Champion from the Blue Corner, Kai Ting Chuang!
Listen to the ovation! It's a Chinese victory! Kai Ting Chuang! The dream becomes a reality. The fairy tale comes true. The young woman who was orphaned and then raised and rescued by her grandparents is now standing on top of the world. That is something special. That is a Cinderella story. That is One Super Series Atomweight World Champion Kai Ting Chuang.
When we return, we take a look at when Ev Ting collided with Nobutatsu Suzuki. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. This 6th of October at One Kingdom of Heroes, the stage is set for a night of superstar martial artists vying for their chance to reach the top of the One Championship ranks. An incredible lineup of martial artists are on the cards at One Kingdom of Heroes. In our One Super Series bouts, Andy Sauer squares off with Anthony Joquani in the kickboxing bout, and 4-time Lumpini Muay Thai World Champion Nong O Gyeong Hadao takes on Mehdi Zatu. Vying for supremacy at the very top of the One Championship ranks is Asia's most accomplished martial artist, Shinya Aoki and Ev Ting. Both of them collide in the lightweight division.
I wore this gold chain for a reason. The only gold I don't have is that thing around my waist.
I feel like I'm that lightweight underdog. I'm that gatekeeper that's fighting all these veterans. Koji Ando, Kamal Shalavus, Ariel Sexton, all the legends, all the ex-champions. I've got the most wins against Team Lakai, pretty much the whole roster on my record. I've came a long way to be fighting names and not have anything to show for. winning the world title would be the pinnacle of my career. Absolutely, it would be the best thing to happen in my life. It would just be such a relief to have something to show for after all these years of grinding, just training, looking after yourself, looking after your injuries, all your training partners that's grinding with you. It's just to really solidify that hard work does pay off.
Let's revisit the match where Ev Ting defeated Nobutatsu Suzuki via TKO at One Quest for Greatness.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is three rounds of 5 minutes in a one championship lightweight bout and is brought to you by GoDaddy. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is the former one welterweight world champion, standing at 173 centimeters tall, holding a record of 11 wins, 2 losses, and 2 draws. Representing hybrid fighter from Japan, he is Nobutatsu Suzuki. And now, introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He is a New Zealand featherweight champion, standing at 170 centimeters tall, holding a record of 13 wins and 4 losses. Representing Auckland MMA from Malaysia, he is F.E.T. Chang.
Kyokushin karate regarded as the hardest form of karate. Its founder, Soso Masoyama, was the only man to ever complete a 300-man kumite, in which he beat 300 black belts in 3 days.
Ready?
He'd also battle bulls and cut their horns off his shuto knife hand strikes to prove just how powerful Kyokushin karate is. It's the style of Nobutatsu Suzuki in the maroon trunks here. This fight brought to you by GoDaddy. Maegedi front kick there from Suzuki. Looking for a side kick is Ev Ting.
Michael Sovello, the Wikipedia of martial arts.
It's great to see so many styles in play on the biggest martial arts stage in the World One Championship. Very side-on stance here from Ev Ting, had an 8-week training camp in Auckland. Suzuki, also an 8-week camp over in Japan, worked on his striking. If he hits Ev Ting clean with that right hand, Ev's gonna roll all the way into the Malacca Straits.
Very traditional straight punch coming from Suzuki. Nice single leg there attempt by Ev Ting as he pushes Suzuki up against the cage.
Ting threads the left hand nicely. The Malaysian New Zealander from the fighting city of Auckland. A beautiful cartwheel kick there. Channeling a little bit of his own inner Muay Thai, bit of Senchai style there from Ev Ting.
Ting says that right kick is gonna be open in a lot of spaces, especially when Suzuki switches to an orthodox stance. He's got that right leg kick and that low hand, Suzuki leaves it open for a right high kick.
Ev Ting very fast and deceptive with the right hand counter on the back foot, the fadeaway right hand from Ev Ting. Suzuki tried to grapple with him and drill the knees, and Ev Ting escaped. Ev Ting's right hand has already inflicted damage on Nobutatsu Suzuki. Beautiful right hand again, followed by the short left.
Again,
straight
right
punches
hand.
Doing the damage here, Mitch.
That right hand is doing it, man. Michael, he sneaks it right through. The minute Suzuki drops that left hand, boom, Ting comes straight in.
Jab two. Looping punch there from Ev Ting. Tries to check the kick, Suzuki. Ting pounces on him. Ting, will it look for a takedown? Can he take out that support left leg of Suzuki?
He tries to go the other way, but good defense. You can see Suzuki trying to get under that head, trying to push his head upwards so Ting can't drop down and take his hips, but he does it anyway.
Big takedown from Ev Ting. Slamming Suzuki onto the floor. Turns the knuckles in for a couple of left hands to the side of the head. Inside of half guard, Ev Ting, 2:10 remaining, first round. Been a ripper so far for the Kiwi.
guard. He's gonna try to frame out, start to posture up, either look to pass or maybe start to sneak Suzuki away from the cage so he's not able to pop back up.
For those who don't know what a kiwi is, it's the emblem of New Zealand. It's a flightless bird. New Zealanders are called kiwis.
That was a fruit.
It could be a kiwi fruit as well. Oh, nice left and right here. The ground and pound from Irv Ting. Here comes the power of Ting. He's unloading. Oh, yes, the big kibosh. It's good night, Irene. Irv Ting scores the win for Malaysia and New Zealand.
Beautifully done. Ting created a little bit of space and let the ground and pound go. The hands came so fast, Michael. The slightest opening and just let them go.
MG once again, a ground and pound machine. He said he worked on his strength and conditioning, and certainly the strength came into play. He predicted he'd finish Suzuki in the first two rounds. He said, look out for the ground and pound. And indeed, it proved to be prophetic for MET Ting. He called it yesterday. He delivered tonight. Just rapid blows down on a hapless Nobutatsu Suzuki. Suzuki, no place to go. And just like that, cue the airplane celebration. Ting beats the former champion. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Has put a stop to this fight after 3 minutes and 29 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of referee stoppage due to strikes. And Ting!
Certainly, it was electrifying. Wherever you're watching in 128 countries around the world, potential viewing audience of more than 1 billion. I hope you enjoyed that by Irv Ting just as much as we did.
When we return, we take a look at the sheer speed of Alain Ngalani's knockout power. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. On the 6th of October, One Kingdom of Heroes promises to be a night of high-octane martial arts action. In the prelims, Alain the Panther Ngalani faces Andre the Giant Meunier in a One Super Series kickboxing bout.
You have to check out this match between Ngalani and Andre Meunier. Both guys are big, powerful strikers.
Alain Ngalani, the man with the most muscles in the martial arts world, and he's got technique to add to that. This is a man who can spin like a top and throw hook kicks to the head that knocks opponents out cold. Every time Ngalani is in the ring, it is excitement.
Andre Meunier is a multi-time world champion who's got big power. So there is nothing that this guy is scared of. He carries heavy, heavy hands, and he throws them with bad intentions.
You've got two men who do not know how to take a backward step. Ngalani knocks out everyone. Meunier knocks out everyone. Ngalani does it with his kicks. Meunier does it with his hands. Will it be Galani's distance? Will it be Meunier on the inside? So many variables, so much to think about. But one thing I know, Ngalani versus Meunier, the irresistible force versus the immovable object will end in a knockout. You can take that to the bank.
Let's relive the moment when Ngalani was the talk of the town, when he recorded the fastest knockout in One heavyweight history.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in a One Championship heavyweight bout. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, He is a seven-time BJJ champion, standing at 176 centimeters tall, holding a record of 7 wins and 1 loss, representing Bonsai Bull Terrier from Japan, presenting Hideki Srisakete! And now, introducing his opponent out of the red corner, he is a Muay Thai kickboxing world champion, standing at 180 centimeters tall, holding a professional kickboxing record of 25 wins, 7 losses, and 1 draw. Representing Impact MMA from Hong Kong, he is Alain the Panther Ngalani.
Look at the physique here on Ngalani. Someone forgot to tell Ngalani that Mr. Olympia is in Las Vegas tonight, not here in Jakarta. Sellout crowd in Jakarta.
Ready, go!
And the size of Sakina's head, it's got its own gravitational pull. Charges after Ngalani early. Looking for a takedown and trying to put hands. Oh, Ngalani catches him! It's good night, Irene! My word! It's over in a matter of seconds! And Sakina is out cold! Open the fridge, he's out cold!
Sakine rushes Ngalani, and you can just see Ngalani waiting, timing, pinpointing the knockout blow, and ends the night of Sakine. Look at this, beautifully timed, measured with the left hand, delivered with the right.
Mitch, it was a combination of timing, precision, and Sakine's own forward-coming momentum that dropped himself into that right hand.
He basically just ran right into that giant right hand of Alain Ngalani.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee Yuji Shimada has put a stop to this contest after 11 seconds in the first round. For your winner by way of knockout, Alain Ngalani.
Ngalani was spot on yesterday. He said that Sakine focuses too much on the takedown and that would leave his big chin exposed. And indeed, that was the case.
Get ready for the biggest blockbuster in ONE Championship history when ONE Kingdom of Heroes electrifies Bangkok's Impact Arena with the world's most exciting martial arts action. Headlining the event is WBC Super Flyweight World Champion and Thai hero, Srisaket Sor Rungvisai. His opponent is a WBC Latino Super Flyweight Champion, Iran Diaz from Mexico. The co-main event also promises fireworks. ONE Kickboxing Atomweight World Champion, Kai Ting Chuang, defends her belt against Thailand's very own women's striking sensation, Stamp Fairtex. And in Yangon, at ONE Pursuit of Greatness, in the main event, two-division kingpin Ong La Unsang will defend his ONE middleweight world title for the second time against the undefeated Mohamed Karaki. Check your local listings. You've been watching ONE Championship Weekly. Press the red button to subscribe.